Hey, it's Roger Roger, and today this video is about destroying the cancer boogeyman. Destroying the cancer boogeyman. There is so much fear and disinformation, misinformation propagated in the media and medical science that there is no cure for cancer. Now, by their definition, you know, Dr. Robert Morse, I encourage you to check out his website, Dr. Robert Morse. Guy's a genius in terms of diet, and he's had many, many cases of people being completely cured of cancer. But of course, he can't say that because there is no cure for cancer. And so he has a hefty legal defense team to protect him and his business from the various legal assaults that come from the medical community trying to say that there's no cure for cancer. Now, they say that what cancer really is, it's a signal for you to change your life. Things are going to change. You can't keep eating meat pies and fish and chips and chocolate and drinking, you know, a carton of beer a week or day or whiskey. And, you know, you can't keep doing the same stuff that you've been doing. So cancer is just a signal change. It's not a death sentence. Everyone's going to go one day. We're all going to die one day. It's just a matter of when. So your body, I will argue, till the sun comes down, has everything it needs to cure itself. But you've really got to start understanding that cancer is just a signal to change. It's just saying change your life. Change your diet, change your emotions, change your habits, change your work environment, change your home environment, improve your personal relationships, improve everything. It's change the way you perceive the world, change the way that you perceive yourself. Cancer is just saying change. That's all it's saying. It's not a boogeyman. It's not this incurable disease. It's just a signal to change. Now, you've got to get it early. You've got to get it early. That, you know, the number one way to get rid of cancer is to get rid of the lymph in your body, because the lymph is like the sewage system in the body. It gets rid of the sewage, the waste from your cells. And if that waste is not filtered out of your kidneys, then what's going to happen is that it accumulates in the body. It develops what scientists call tumors, cancerous tumors, which is really, you know, Dr. Morse explains it better, but I'm really just shotgunning it here. Dr. Morse says that tumors in the body, cancerous tumors, are really what it is that it's waste in the body that is not being filtered through your kidneys because your kidneys are blocked. And so the only way for that your body to deal with that waste is to surround it in a tumor to protect you, because if it's a highly acidic waste in your body, you know what acid does? It burns. So your body protects it. It surrounds the acidic, you know, acidic, you know, lymph node or acidic concentration in your body with a tumor in order to protect you, because it doesn't want that to kill you. And so tumors are not necessarily a bad thing. It's just your body trying to protect you and its way. So what doctors do with chemotherapy and that, they blast the tumor with all kinds of radiation, which also kills the good cells and totally wipes out your immune system for a period of time until it recovers. So again, you need to check out Dr. Morse. He explains it really, really well. So you got to get your kidneys filtering. And the way to get your kidneys filtering again is to filtering your waste and the acid out of your body is to have fresh fruits. Fruit smoothies, fruit juices, not the bottled kind from the supermarket with lots of sugars. Sugar is acid, but fructose, real fruit, and, you know, vegetable smoothies, salads, all that stuff is going to do you really so well in terms of healing cancer. Then you've also got to look at the emotional component of your healing. By looking at your emotional side of things, it's about moving away from all the negative, angry, resentful emotions. They really drag you down. They shut down your immune system. They put you in fight or flight survival mode. Also, you got to look at your workplace. If your workplace is quite toxic, it's a negative environment, negative co-workers, negative managers, you may need to look at moving on just for your health, to change your life. And if your relationship is toxic and your home environment is toxic, you need to look at ways that you can improve that and change that so it's more positive and more full of love and peace and you know, all those kind of good emotions. So really, that's all cancer is saying. It's saying it's a good thing because it wakes you up to the need to change your life, the need to move forward. Okay? And, you know, drinking copious amounts of alcohol, not good. A lot of acid, blocking up your kidneys, it's not good for you. So it's just a call to change. It's not a death sentence. Change your diet, change your attitude, you'll heal. Guarantee you'll heal. You got to do it. Have an awesome day.